Hello and welcome back to the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today I have another magnificent leader and episode for you, but before I go ahead, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also go back and check out all the previous guests and magnificent content there. Also, before I go ahead, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also check our digital health platform CliniTouch V and our series partner Fujifilm Healthcare. Now gives me great pleasure to introduce you to David Chou. He's a global healthcare CIO and also a digital health influencer. David, how are you?
I'm well. Thank you so much for having me. Excited to be here to chat with you.
Oh, thanks for accepting the invite. And today we are here to talk about digital transformation in healthcare, and you certainly have a lot of experience in that domain. I'm looking forward to the interview. I'll go ahead with the questions, David. Is that okay?
Perfect.
Brilliant. So the first question that I have for you, David, is can you share with us some of the major trends in health systems?
Yeah, I would say some of the major trends from a health system perspective is we are moving away from providing care within the four walls of the hospital. It is really moving towards where the patients are at. So obviously, virtual care, telemedicine is one way, and that's been in play for quite some long time. Adoption relatively slow. Now it has been picking up the last 2 years, but it doesn't mean that just because you offer telemedicine, you have a competitive advantage. I think the next chapter is people are thinking about, can we provide concierge care? Can we also provide hospital at the home? So these are some of the major initiatives that leading prominent health systems are thinking about in terms of their transformation. Now, when we talk about digital transformation, I always get a chuckle because it's been such an overhyped and overused buzzwords, and you can't buy it, right? It's not something I could just go buy and say, okay, help me transform, let me buy digital transformation. It really has to come from reinventing your operating model, changing the mentality and the culture, and thinking about how you could use technology to be that differentiator. So, you know, what are those scenarios I just described from a health system perspective, it is really changing how we operate, because if you talk about something as simple as hospital at home, your goal is, can you take your current inpatient hospital room and transform that to the living room of the patient? You won't be able to do all the complex stuff, but some of the simple stuff is where you could get a head start, but it's not as easy. Think about something like logistics. Right, getting medical supplies to the patient's home will be a challenge, because all of a sudden you became a warehouse distributor, almost like Amazon. So how are you going to get that delivery to the patient's home in 1 or 2 days? Are you going to set up an entire operation to do that, or are you going to partner with a third party? Now, these are things that organizations need to think about end to end. It's not just a technology play. It's not just a clinical staff's role. It's really end to end. So I think that's where the opportunity lies for an organization to really get to that so-called digital transformation.
Oh, brilliant, David. Thank you so much for that. And you mentioned very important aspects, the culture, the technology. It's not as simple as buy a product and fix it up. It's more complex than that. And you mentioned certainly we're moving away from the hospital setting to home settings, care settings. Also now we've seen like virtual care becoming the norm going forward. So you gave amazing insights there. Thank you so much, David. That leads nicely to the second question, which is, what's the role of the next generation digital leader?
Yeah, when I look at the healthcare space, specifically on the provider side, historically you have the chief information officer, the CIO, But now you're starting to see what pops up as the chief digital officer. You have also seen individuals get both titles. I would say in 2016, I was really trying to emphasize that at a recent organization where I really pushed to have both the chief information and digital officer title. And I remember a lot of my peers would look at me and say, why are you adding this digital piece to it? My intent was really to help drive business outcomes, but to also help set a different mentality of where we're thinking digital first and utilizing that culture to where we embrace technology. What I am seeing right now, where you have a lot of traditional CIOs and they're sort of falling behind, is they're still focused on technology rather than the business of healthcare operations and providing that deep value. So when that happens, you know, CEO may say, well, I have a CIO that has done a great job of managing infrastructure, managing enterprise applications, but doesn't really help me drive the organization or drive a better patient experience. Maybe I need to go find someone from the outside and come in and be that chief digital officer. And that's when you start to see some tensions to where there's some overlap and it gets really gray in terms of who owns the technology stack. So I would say the next generation digital leader ideally should be the CIO, but we're starting to see a trend to where there is a digital officer that's coming in play. And if I had to summarize what that would look like, essentially you have the digital officer doing all the cool stuff while the traditional CIO is managing the day-to-day operation of making sure the technology is functional. So for aspiring CIOs who are really thinking about where they could help and benefit the organization, start reshaping your mindset and really thinking about how you could provide a lot more business value by connecting the various dots of the technology stack or even operationally. I think one of the things I have been really focused on, and that's where my leadership team uses me, is really to connect the various dots. Because in our seat as a CIO, we see all the various operational process. We see how the technology fits in, and not every leader in the organization gets to be able to have that visibility. So it's important for CIOs to really understand how they could connect the dots and put together innovative solutions for the organization.
Oh, brilliant. David, thank you so much for that overview. And also, like, very important roles that really overlap and intersect with each other. And now, as you mentioned, probably when you mentioned in 2016, people were a bit shocked because it was not a usual position. It was a bit of a new thing. But now we certainly see a lot of digital offices, I mean, digital data offices, I mean, coming to the picture. So thank you so much. And you mentioned a very important dynamic there to focus on where the strength lies in terms of skill set and everything. So thank you, David. And the last question that I have for you is, what are the differences between digitizing and digitalizing in healthcare transformation?
Yeah, digitizing, you got to take it to operations, right? Nothing really matters until you operationalize it. And part of the task for this digital leader is they need to really help the organization transform their operating model. So prime example, let's just say you want to really do that transformation in supply chain, get it to a completely digital world. Well, before you buy any cool technology is not going to solve that problem. You have to really change your process and your operating model. And most organizations, they probably never changed their operating model for the last 10 to 15 years in something like supply chain. So I think part of that, what you just described, is take it from concept to reality by transforming and changing your operating model completely 180 degrees. And once you have done that, then you can look at the technology solution that's a good fit. But also there's times when you need to really transform your operating model to fit a technology, right? And I think historically people would always say people, process, technology, let's make sure they are all in sync. Well, there are some times when a technology software or a product is designed to in a certain operating model. So as an organization and a user, you will definitely need to adapt to it. It can't just be my way or the highway. So I think there's some give and take there, but that's how I view what you just described in that question in terms of digitizing. It's really taking it to reality.
Brilliant, David. Thank you so much. David, we come to the end of the episode. I'm not sure if you seen other episodes. I have one last remark. It's not really a question as such. It's called 1 minute of fame. You can talk about anything, about personal life, personal experiences, work, college, shout out to any company, anything whatsoever to round up the episode. 1 minute of fame, over to you.
1 minute of fame, huh? Mm-hmm. I would say, you know, a little bit about me is just my passion for building new business models, helping organizations get creative. And some of the work that have been put together have been featured in various trade shows, articles, and so forth. But I think where I really get my passion is just from working in the various communities. So hopefully for the folks that are watching, that are subscribing, reach out anytime if I could provide guidance and help you guys really transform your organization by making technology a competitive advantage. Thank you.
Brilliant, David. I'm going to wrap up, but before, let me thank you again for your time, magnificent expertise here for our viewers and listeners. And thank you so much for contributing again to this magnificent content. And David, nice to see you.
Thank you.
I'm going to wrap up now, so make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to post the links here to connect with David, follow his Twitter, and connect with him on LinkedIn. Ask him questions. You can see he's a true expert about his work and everything else. And also acknowledge our digital health platform, CliniTouch V, and our series partner, Fujifilm Healthcare. And I'll see you all next week.